ReefDudes is sponsored by Ecotech Marine and Bulk Reef Supply.
Today we're going to go through a complete beginner guide on how to set up the Ecotech Versa. What's going on, guys? Devin from ReefDudes. So yesterday a buddy reached out to me and he asked me how to set up a Versa. He's got a Kalk reactor and a Versa and wanted to set it up. I figured why not make a complete kind of beginner's video on how to set it up and use it for different uses. So we're going to start with our Versa, take her out of the box. There is a quick start guide that basically tells you to download Mobius. Now I'm going to assume you already have Mobius. If not, you can get that from your app store. We have our Versa. We got some lube for the tube. We got some mounting stuff, a little calibration container, and our power supply. Pump is plugged in. Now from here, you're gonna wanna launch the Mobius app. And if we click on the top right, let's just make a test aquarium for this one. So you'd set up a new tank. I'm just gonna call this one test. And it finds gear that's not currently Mobius. So right here we see our Versa. So I'm gonna click on the Versa and hit next. And it's gonna check the firmware. And if it needs a firmware update, it's gonna apply that to it. Have a sample copy, of course. Now it's gonna ask you what you wanna use it for. So there is a bunch of built-in stuff. So you can, if you wanna dose for calcium or alkalinity. So say you're using it as a regular dosing pump. So we'll just say we're dosing alkalinity. It can ask, what is your daily dosage? So let's say we dose 20 mils a day and activate. Now, right now, if we go into our pump, it's gonna dose 20 mils a day and it's gonna do it between that certain, or smart mode. Okay, so smart mode is gonna think when it's the best time to dose it for you. And it's gonna do it within that range. Now, if you're gonna dose in calcium, alkalinity, magnesium, it's likely gonna offset them all for you. If you go into a custom mode, you can set the time yourself. And this is generally how I've done it. So if you wanted to dose it, say, just at nighttime, you can go from 12 a.m. to 12 p.m. and you can either click the from the two and type it in, or you can just drag down the bar on the left and that will do it that way for you. Now there is a thing called catch up. This means if for whatever reason the pump is off, it didn't get to dose, when it gets power, it'll catch up to make sure it meets that 20 mils a day. Now, if you wanted it to dose 20 mils over 24 hours, again, you could just drag the full bar across it and you'd be dosing it 24 hours a day. Now, so that's basically how you do for regular dosing. Again, if you're doing like a trace element, what rate you dose at is gonna depend on the duration. So if we look at the very bottom there, it says the rate of 0.27. So it's dosing extremely slow over the hour and a half. And if I drag it larger, you'll see it's 0.08 mils or 0.01 mils. So you can choose to dose something very fast or very quick, depending on your duration of the dosing period. I tend to just dose, I like to dose things consistently throughout the day. So let's delete this one. So for additive, else inside of here, so we got trace elements. So again, this will be a very smart, very tiny one. So we'll say dose this one, we'll dose 1 mil. And you can see it doses over 3 seconds, so it's a very quick little dose. Now, if you wanted it to manually do a dose, we got this little dropper here. If I click the dropper, I can say dose, so defaults 30 mils over 1 minute. If I say 30 mils over 30 seconds, then it's gonna dose 60 mils a minute, hit dose. And now you can see the pump's dosing and it'd be dosing that 30 mils. Now, if you are using this for additive dosing, it is a good idea to calibrate it. If you're using it for something like a calcium reactor, a Kalk reactor, I personally haven't bothered doing it because I don't really care if it's a little bit off because you're running it 24/7 in those cases. Now, if you're using this for precise amounts of trace elements or alkalinity, then you probably want to calibrate it. To do that, we're on the Versa screen, we hit the little gear at the top. And there's a calibrate button. And from here, it shows your dosage and duration. So you can customize that. If you're dosing trace elements, I would do a very small dose over a small duration, you know, like 5 mil type of thing. If you're doing large dosing, then again, you can set a larger duration. You kind of want to calibrate it to the scenario you're using it in. So with that, again, we would take our dosing lines. Now with these, there's little barb adapters and you can use the soft tubing. I always just use RODI line, that's always my go-to for dosing. But we would hit start and right now it'd be dosing. So over 2 minutes, it's gonna dose however many mils that said and the app's gonna ask you how much it'd dose. Once we enter that, it is calibrated. So I'm gonna hit stop for now. Now we can try some different ones. If we want to do a water change, for instance, you can say, here's your water change, how many mils do you want to do? So say we want to do 1 gallon, so or say 4,000 mils, and you can say activate. Now, if we click in our schedule, it's going to do 4 liters throughout the day. So it's just going to very slowly drip new water in or out of the tank. This is what I was previously doing on my tank. I had one taking out, and I did this over a 2-hour period, I believe. And I had one taking out, one adding at the same time. So when you do it that way, you have two pumps, and your ATO is running to no difference because you're taking and adding at the exact same time. So your water on the tank never changes. So that's a really cool way with like next to no impact on the tank, but still getting the benefits of the water change. Now, one question I get asked all the time is it less efficient than taking out than adding? It is slightly, but it's negligible. I did read a bunch of kind of scientific stuff on this day, and it was, I think it was like 96 or 97% still effective type of thing. So you lose a few percent of efficiency, but it's not enough to worry about for the convenience of it. So that's kind of how I worked it. Another thing that I've learned too is they work much better at pushing over a very long distance than sucking and kind of pulling. So I have one, I have a Versa downstairs on the floor below me on my mixing station that pushes all the way up to the top floor. And then I have one at the top floor that pushes water down to the bottom. And I find that works very well for doing the auto water changes. Now, if we're gonna use this for either a calcium reactor or a Kalk reactor, it's gonna be a very similar thing. I tend to go into custom and daily dosage. So if you are using this for a calcium reactor, for instance, we can say 40 mils, go into it. And on the top here, it is custom. I go into here and say continuous. So continuous is what I use on my Kalk and my calcium, the rate. So if we say for my calcium reactor on the tank, it's anywhere from 40 to say 60 mils a minute. If I say 40 mils a minute, say go, now it's going to start dosing. It should be spinning right now. So now it's going to be dosing at 40 mils a minute, and we can see our daily volume is 58 liters. Now, same thing, if we are doing, let's say 20 mils a minute, I hit save, now we got 29 liters a day. So if you're using this for a calcium reactor, again, I kind of set it, test your alkalinity, and if you need more elk, dose a bit more. You need less elk, dose a bit less. So super easy that way to adjust. And you, so, and a heavy tank like mine, I have a steady stream coming out. If you have a lower demand tank, you're probably just getting a bit of a drip coming out. Now, the other one you can do is for using for a Kalk reactor. Darren, this one's for you. So very similar thing for doing a Kalk reactor. So I would come in here in templates. I would just go to custom. You can say activate, oh, volume's too small. So activate, and then click on your schedule. And I always just use continuous because I like that slow drip throughout the day consistently. Now, if you wanted to do it for a certain amount, say you only want to dose Kalk at night, then you could go into custom, hit your plus sign, and same thing, because I only want to dose Kalk from, let's say 1,000 mils from 12 a.m. to 12 p.m. Now you got your 12-hour dosing of Kalk. And how much do you want to dose over that period? Let's say you want to do 3,000 mils. Hit that, hit save. Done. Now it's going to dose during those periods. Now, right now it is 10 in the morning, so actually that's about right, so it should be running. Just that little bar right on the graph shows you where you are in the schedule, it gives you an idea. Now, if you want to dose in a certain period, that's the way to do it. Or if you want it 24 hours, literally drag your bar down, hit save, now you're dosing it over 24 hours. So it's really easy to customize on that front. Now, if you want to name your Versa, at the top, hit the gear, say device name, we'll just say test. Now we can see at the top it says test run when we're in there, or if we're looking at our devices page, we can see it says test. So I like to name mine Forfus Calcium Elk AWC for auto water change, just to say what it is. So super duper easy to set up, super super duper versatile. You could be dosing 0.01 mil of a trace element, or you can be doing a couple hundred mils a minute for an auto water change or large volume stuff. So really cool pumps, really, really easy to set up via Mobius and the Bluetooth app. Hopefully that answered all of you guys' questions. Those are all the scenarios that I've used them for. Trace elements, water changes, calcium reactors, Kalkwasser reactors. So super, super versatile you can do with these little guys. Now, if I missed anything or something you want me to dig into further, let me know in the comments below. If you're new, this helped you out, be sure to hit that like button. Be sure to hit that subscribe button. I'll catch you guys in a future video.